Well, this film is kind of special for me because my previous films, shorts and mid-length, they came from the impression of visiting the place. Like in Chechnya, I just came and I understood that I can't go by, I need to make a film there. And here, this film came from the abstract idea. It was 6 years ago when I read a travel blog of the people who went around Kola Peninsula by feet. And then they described places that they visit, and they visited one of these Soviet towns, which appeared as a military town, as a military base, and they described crazy things happening, like totally surreal, you know. When I read about it and I looked at the photos, and well, the people should never live there. How did it happen that the people live there? And because it is cold, there is no there is no, you know, like a reason for the people to stay there. Still, they do, and it turns out in a very surreal way of living. And then I thought that I should make the film about one of these Soviet towns. And actually, during the Soviet Union, these places appeared as military bases or as gulag labor camps. And then they turned out into the towns, and people started to live there. And Apatite, the film, the place which we filmed, is one of these Soviet towns. It appeared like a labor camp, and then they started to dig the ore there, and then the town appeared. No other reason for appearing this town at the plant. there is no other reason for appearing this town at the plant Earth. And when I came there, I knew a little bit. I knew that there is only Soviet buildings, that there is only Soviet culture and people, former prisoners or the people who came for work there. And yeah, immediately I saw this surreal style of living, because you always live in a surreal way when you live at the place where you're not supposed to live. And this first research we made with the camera, and immediately we met our protagonists, just like by chance. And I made a 1 year long research after this, but main characters remain the same as we met at during the first filming. No, we found this form very intuitively. I had this construction on immortality, and I saw these people as they imagined themselves, cosmic heroes or something like this. Yes, I imagined this, I had this image in my head, but I didn't know how will this grow. And for example, the key to this filming the people came when we filmed the patriotic show. It was just, you know, like so aggressive and everything that we decided that we put the camera not in front but on the back. And then when it started and we started to see the people from their backs, looking into the abyss, because at the stage you can't see the hole. And it was a feeling that these children dance at the edge of the abyss. It was so interesting. And then we started to find this image of filming people with no faces, that was something that you can see at the bus stop. I think it gives this image of some kind of heroic stuff, something that the people imagine themselves on the one hand, and on the other hand it shows this process of losing their self-identity, because the plot of the film is based around this propagandistic education which aims to make the people be kind of part of this machine, if it can be said like this, the best element of the machine shouldn't have any face. So it was important for me to show, to fill the screen, to film the people from the backs, have kind of, as I say, the back portraits. So I had a feeling, because it's a very old place with a great history. Part of which we don't remember already, but I had a feeling of a tired town, the town which is tired of the war, of the conflicts, and when you can see this Sarajevo very nice posters, it's sometimes based on the some how to say tired buildings. Yes. And I think it's a very big joy for the people to have a real fest, because when you live in the war conditions for quite a long, you just need to have some joy. And it's good that this festival gives to the people an opportunity to watch beautiful films, to open a little bit different reality, because still, I think the conflict here is not solved yet, in a sense that everybody would be happy with it. And it's good to switch off and to just for the people to get experience of different places and different stories which happen not here. I think it's a great thing that this festival exists here.